Hello everyone, my name is Pixlriffs, welcome back to Fez. We're going to head over here for a second because this place seems a little bit less confusing than the last, and there are still a couple of things we have not yet explored in this little area. For example, there's a cube bit right up there that I hadn't collected, first of all. And Dot is letting me know that there's something up here, so I presume that's what it wants us to get. That's 6 out of 8 for that cube, and we need 2 to progress through the place with all of the doors. Which seems important. You always got to rotate around these places, because there are cube bits hiding in every little odd location. I've not yet got to the point where I'm confident enough to, like, jump and rotate my perspective as I go. Like, we could do that over here, and then I'd be, like, jumping into nothing. It's so weird, but I imagine that'll be used to solve puzzles later on. There are a couple of other doors over here that we can enter into, and I have a feeling that one is going to take us, yeah, out there into the distance, where I'm sure there are some cube bits lurking here and there. But this place seems very expansive, and I'm not sure which direction we need to go next. I wonder if there are some bits we can grab onto. Yes, there are. Very cool, very cool. Despite the fact that they're shaded a certain way to make it look like they are three-dimensional, so you can kind of get a clue about where you're going, you can still just jump past those things, which is really weird. It's not what I'm used to in a game. That's the really weird thing. This thing seems to be pointing downwards. I wonder if there is something there that we can drop to, maybe. I'm not sure. That's interesting. Is this crate up here something we can open? I'm not sure about that either. Wait a second. This is looking like the place that was on that map. Yeah, it is. Okay, right. So I was wrong about the location in the last video. It's actually this place. Oh, hello. Hello, you. Let me mosey around the side of this building and hoop, we got it. That's the end of one cube and the beginning of a next. So that's 3 cubes to our name so far. We're well on our way, folks. And you can jump out of puzzles that way. Interesting times. So, let's make our way over to that one if we can. I feel like that box over there has got to be important for something, though. So I wonder what it is. You can just jump up there. That's so cool. Oh, little snail. Look at you. You see the world in 3 dimensions. Nice. A treasure chest. And press X. Yep, we have the knowledge about this one anyway. We got ourselves another key. Fantastic. No idea what the key is for. I haven't found any more locked doors yet, but we can find it. I think we'll track down a chest or two here or there. We jump down there. Can we jump down to that from this? Can we? Nope, apparently not. Oh dear. Sorry, Gomez. I'm sorry, Gomez. We can probably get down there, though. So let's hoppity down here. And I'm fairly certain that we'll be able to get to that treasure chest over there somehow. I wonder how, though. Right, if we get onto the edge of this, and then there. Careful. Yeah, okay, now we can drop down onto this cube bit. Nice! And then let's drop down onto this crate to see if this is anything at all. Because Dot seems to be excited about something over here. This is a crate, obviously. You can push a crate by leaning on it. So, block puzzles. You can pick it up and throw it. And you can drop it down gently by pressing down and X. Okay. So I wonder if we need to put this here somehow. Dot is definitely indicating that we do. Can we put it down on this? Maybe? Oh, you throw it on there. Oh, exciting. And that opens a door. Nice. You did it. You found a secret passage. Yeah, we did. Okay, so those are crates. Those are definitely crates that we can use. But also, I need to find out what's going on up here with the... Ouch. I need to find out what's going on up here with the treasure map. Because there's definitely a chest up there that we could maybe get access to. From the right rotation, the right perspective. Or if there is some kind of hidden... Oh. If there's some kind of hidden island there that we have yet to discover. And that's my hunch. What do you guys think? Let's give it a try. Let's rotate our perspective around here. Let's hibbity hop up there and... Hello, you. Because, yeah, there was a small tree here, there was a big tree here. And then if you rotate it to this perspective, I'm pretty sure, where's the inventory? I'm pretty sure that matches up with our treasure map here. Because that's... Wait a second. We need to have it rotate around the correct way, which I think is that way. Because then it looks like this. And maybe there is a hidden platform in the sky. There is! I was right! I was right, sir! And, oh, goodness me. And it disappears if we rotate it to a different perspective. So now we've got to do one of these and rotate it the right way around. I'm going to kill him so often with this. Yes. Okay, so if we jump and we rotate right at the last second, then maybe we have a chance. Gonna have to bullet time it a little bit here. So which way around can we go? It's a bit of a long jump. I don't think we can make it under our own steam. Hmm. Interesting. I saved myself that time. That was pretty good. Right, so... Huh. There's something to this. There's a trick to it. I just don't know what. For a start, we need to get back onto this tree. And so if we're that way round... That way round. That's the way the platform appears. And then if we jump a bunch over there and then rotate that way, then maybe we can do it. Maybe not. Wait a second. Looking at this, if you rotate the treasure map around, the platform is closer to the island. So that means, presuming that... Right, the opposite side of that is just the reverse. So if we complete a full rotation in perspective, there's a closer island. There is! Oh, brilliant! That's so good! So good, we made it! I can't believe that took me so long. But I guess we just had to look at it the right way around. Pretty much all the puzzles in this game are look at it the right way around. What is that? You found your first anti-cube. For every cube, there is an anti-cube, a negative for every positive. Anti-cubes are much harder to find than regular cubes. You found 4 cubes. Now you can open that door we saw earlier, you know, the one that's just outside of your village. Yeah, but... So anti-cubes aren't like... They don't... Anti-cubes, right, so that's opened up the fourth face of this. They don't count as, like... They don't count against you. So I feel like the name anti-cubes kind of implies that they're bad and you shouldn't have them, but... So they're just, like, difficult puzzle cubes. Oh, I love that. That's so clever. So freaking clever. Whoa, okay. Yeah, maybe you shouldn't drop too far off of that. Anyway, let's move on. Now we can open that door, but... There are definitely some more things around here to find. Let's not jump to that. There we go. Let's hop our way down slowly and gently this time. Thank you. Thank you very much. Do Dude, I'm kind of glad I figured that out on my own. If I had to, like, look it up or something, I probably never have forgiven myself. But that opened the secret door down here that we need to go to. We haven't been down this way yet. So I wonder what's down here. Let's find out. Into the mysterious door we go. Where it goes, nobody knows. Okay, moving island. Very cool. Let's hop our way up here. That one doesn't look like it's getting any closer. Hop. Okay, so we can bring a cube back here, and there's a cube bit up there that I can't reach right now. Yoink. And there's that one, which I can reach right now. Thank you very much. We are 3/8 of the way towards our next cube. Now the question is, can I can sort of jump whilst holding this, but it's not a particularly high jump. So I just gotta be a little bit careful about how I jump. Yeah, there we go. We managed it. I love the soundtrack. This is Disaster Piece, I think, who, if I remember correctly, did the soundtrack for Hyperlight Drifter as well. It sounds very Hyperlight Drifter to me. And the color palette is kind of similar in some ways, so they are very different games, but they have their similarities. Birds of a feather. Sorry, Snail. Don't want to crush you, so you're going to have to... Oh, wow. Hello. Wonder if that would have made that cube bit easier to get to if we hadn't used the crate already. Is there a doorway? There's a doorway. There's always a doorway in this game. Let's go through and see what we have. Oh, interesting. Okay, so this feels like an inside kind of temple-y looking spot. We've got a crate here that we can mosey our way out here. But I don't think we'll be able to complete this as a jumping puzzle. Oh, maybe we will. Maybe we will. Throw it up on there. Yes, good. Good. So many little buttons and things like that that we can press ourselves down onto. And hop. Very nice, Gomez. Well done. Well done. And through we go. Oh, there's a whole cube up there. What? I was not expecting that. That's an entire piece of the cube. What is going on? Hello? What is this? What are you? Oh gosh. That's a warp gate then. I'm guessing. Those were marked on the map, but I had not been to one of them yet. Oh. And where are we now? This looks like a familiar location. Let's check the world map just in case. Yeah, I think we have been here. This comes off of that doorway. Hmm. And that is a doorway back, presumably, to where we were just now. Right? No? No, it isn't. It's somewhere different entirely. This game. Oh, this game is always throwing me a curveball. Little squirrels everywhere. Hello. Oh, they're so cute. I've got to be a little bit careful about how we complete these puzzles, though. And hop. So far, we haven't encountered any, like, animals or whatever which are dangerous to us. Which is good, because obviously we don't really have a way of defending ourselves, but that... It doesn't seem to be, like, imminent danger is part of any of the puzzles yet, you know? Like, there's not something that's gonna, like, kill and eat us if we're not careful. That looks like it's got a door in it. Like, anywhere that symbol appears, that looks like it's probably a secret door. Hyperlight Drifter style, there's a little symbol that tells you where to go. Drawing all kinds of comparisons with Hyperlight Drifter today, apparently. Jump over there, jump onto the vines over here. Nice work. Nice work. He's getting good at jumping now. And around we go. Where it goes, nobody knows. Oh, mushroom forest. Hello. My kind of location. Now, where are we even going? I've completely lost track of where I intended to go at this point. I'm just exploring the world, and the world map is not particularly useful when it comes to telling us where we're at. But a few of these places seem like hubs to a variety of locations. And the game doesn't, I guess it doesn't want you to, like, go back on yourself a whole bunch. Oh, there's a locked door down there, and you know what? We have a key. I wonder what this is. Yeah, I wonder what these are too, because there are a few of them around. There was one at the lighthouse location. Let's go in with the key that we have, because we may as well. And there's a cube bit up there, so we'll probably be able to grab that. Oh, and the little critters and stuff. Ah, falling. There's like little caterpillars and everything. But yes, none of it seems hostile, thankfully. Because I'm not into that right now. I like how peaceful this game is. It feels kind of relaxing, even though the puzzles are a little bit difficult to solve sometimes. It's a workout for the brain, but not for the adrenaline, you know? Oh, okay, those are breaking as we get on them. That's not good. But they respawn. Okay, good to know, because then we can get back up there once we've obtained this little cube bit over here. So you just got to be quick with the rotations. Make your way up here, slowly but surely. Nice. Good work. And in this, we'll probably find another key. Oh no, another treasure map. Even better. Hello. So yeah, these definitely show you where there are hidden platforms. But the... this whole design of map is really different to the other stuff that I've seen. Like, I don't know what this is supposed to represent. It looks like a tower block or something. It looks like a series of doorways that we could jump into. I wonder if there's going to be something that's designed like that later. Oh, that's really weird. If you rotate the perspective, the stuff, like, crumbles onto ledges below it. That's pretty funny. It seems like that's everything we can do in this area for now. So let's head back. Now, how do we get back over there? Can we jump to that one? I think we can jump to that one. Yes, there we go. Okay. I was hoping that it wasn't just going to leave us dangling. I think from here we can probably... we can jump onto this. We can hop it over to there. We can just hop over to there anyway. What is in the shack? Also, can we jump on these mushrooms? Of course we can. The bouncy pads! Oh, wicked! Okay. Okay, well, yeah, that one just bounced me into oblivion, but never mind. There you go. Boing. Boing. And shift. And boing. That's so cool. Mushrooms are the best, you guys. Mushrooms know where it's at. And we're climbing the tree. I wonder what's going to be at the top of this. Hopefully some kind of cube. Doing, 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 doing. Okay, just another doorway. But where is this going to lead to? Goodness only knows. But we're about to find out, folks. That's probably going to be it for this episode, though. I think we've done enough for now. Thank you guys so much for watching Fez. This game is mind-blowing, and I hope you're enjoying it. Leave a like if you did. Subscribe if you want to see more. And I'll see you guys soon. Bye for now.